Good morning. Welcome to the class of social science for class 4, chapter 9, our water resources. I repeat, our water resources. In the content of chapter 9, we will discuss about water. What is water? Characteristics of water. Irrigation. Man-made sources of water or types of irrigation and water conservation. Water, which is said to be a very important natural source, okay? It is very important for to exist in the world. Without water, we cannot survive. Come on, now let's find out what are the characteristics of water and why the water is so much important for us. Water. Water is an important element of planet Earth and it supports life. Without water, no one can survive in the entire world. Almost 72% of the Earth's surface is covered with water. The water on the earth is either present in solid form, it means ice, liquid form, it means the normal water of the rivers, oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, etc. and or in the form of gas. Gas means the water vapor. In the present scenario, across the globe, the consumption of fresh water, I repeat, the consumption of fresh water and underground water has increased to many folds over the ever-rising population. Okay, due to the ever-rising population, due to the increasing population, okay, as you all know that the population is going increasing day by day. So what it had actually made? It had made the consumption, it means the use of fresh water and the consumption of the or the use of the groundwater also in a huge quantity. It means nowadays we are using the groundwater and the fresh water for our health, for our fulfill our needs of water. And why we are using in such a huge quantity? Just because of the increasing in the population. Water is a crucial element of our domestic, agriculture and industrial economy. Yes, water is very important, not only for individual, for us, but it is also important for agriculture. If water will be not there, what will happen? Will be able to grow crops? No, we cannot grow crops without the help of water, because if water will not be present in the land, properly water will not be given to maintain the fertility of the soil, what will happen? The land will become barren. And if the land will become barren, what will happen? Obviously, we will not be able to grow the crops. Now, coming to the industrial economy, how it is useful? Because for many of the processes of making the things, obviously the industries also require water. So, water is very crucial and important, not only for the domestic, for the household works, for washing utensils, washing clothes, okay, drinking water, not only for this, but it is also important for agriculture and industrial economy. So, what actually the water is? Water is an important, the most important element of the planet Earth, in where 72% of the water is of the entire earth is covered with water. Now here, if the entire earth, 72% earth is covered with water, it means it can also be called as a blue planet, and that is why the earth is known as a blue planet, because you all know that the color of the water is blue. Okay, now here the water is present in three forms: solid, it means ice, liquid, it means the normal water, and the gaseous form, it means in the form of water vapor. in the present scenario, in the present days, okay, what we are doing, we are using the fresh water and the underground water in a huge quantity. And why we are doing so? Just because of the increment in the population. Now, let's find out that what are the characteristics of water. Water is a colorless, tasteless and odorless substance. Odorless means over here, which is not having any smell, any fragrance. Okay, essential for survival of living beings. Yes, water is colorless. There is no color of the water. It states there also. Okay, when we mix sugar with water, it becomes sweet. When we mix salt with water, it becomes saline or the salty water. Okay, so it is, and water is a colorless, tasteless and odorless substance. Now, water is an essential element for all human beings, animals and plants. So, water is not only important for human beings, it means for us, but water is also important for animals and plants. Without water, animals and plants cannot survive on this earth. Water comprises of more than 71% of the earth surface. Water is derived with various sources like rivers, lakes, oceans and streams. Now, what does it mean? Water is present over here on this earth in form of several forms, land, okay? In several forms, in several ways, like we have the water, we can get the water from rivers, we can get the water from the oceans, we find water in the lakes, we find water in the streams also. So, water is, we are getting the water from various sources like rivers, lakes, oceans and streams. Water is also used for many domestic purposes like washing clothes, washing utensils, okay, cooking, cleaning, drinking, bathing and etc. So, what usually the characteristics of water we find out, that first thing, that water is colorless, tasteless and odorless substance, which is essential for surviving for the living beings. Water is essential element not only for human beings but also for animals and plants. Now, here on the earth, the water is covering the area of 71%. Water can be get or derived from various sources like rivers, ocean, lakes and streams. And the most important thing over here is that over here for human beings, for us, water is used for many domestic purposes like drinking water, cleaning, cooking, washing, bathing and several other works. Whatever we do at the home. Sometimes your dad used to wash the vehicle, your dad used to wash the car, the scooter or the bike, they require water. For gardening the plants, for watering the plants in your garden, in your home garden, you require water. So there are several domestic works where you use water for our basic needs. Continuing with the characteristics of water, water is an essential component in the agriculture sector, mainly for the purpose of irrigation. For the irrigation, now how the water is helpful for the purpose of irrigation? Look, if we will not water the land, obviously the land will lose its fertility, okay, fertility of soil. And due to which the land will become barren. And if the land will become barren, it will not have the moisture. Okay? It will not uphold the moisture, due to which the land will become barren. And as the land will become barren, the land will not be able to cultivate the crops. So, water is very essential for the agriculture purposes. Water helps in regulating the human body temperature, making cells and tissues to grow. Yes, this is also a very important thing. If we will not have water or we will not drink water from inside, the body, the human body will become dry, okay? The bones will become totally dry and the body temperature will also fluctuate. It means it will go up or down. Water also makes the in the creation or making cells and tissues to grow because of the moisture that the water holds. Water is also crucial for maintaining body functions like breathing, digestion and sweating. This also what? Why these all used to help the water? By the water only? Because you all know that the water is a composition of H2O, that it means hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Oxygen, which is very important for our body. And this used to, that is why the water used to help our body to circulate or to let the many of the parts of the body to perform their functions properly. The industrial purpose of the water, that includes washing, processing, cooling and diluting the products in the manufacturing process. Now see, what does it mean? It means that water in the industrial sector, in the big companies, industries, the water also helps them for washing the products, washing the substances by which they are making the things. Okay, the procedure of making anything, cooling them, it means it has been like this. You all know that iron is always means if we are making any substances from the iron, it is to heat it up and then it is to make cool. Okay, for the cooling purposes and sometimes diluting the product means mixing the products also, they want water in this, by which they can help in the manufacturing process. There are three different forms of water. This you all know earlier. I told you all. What are the three forms of the water present on the earth? First one is solid. Second is the liquid. Okay, liquid it means the water, and the solid comes in a form of ice. And the third one is the water vapor. So water is essential not for the human beings but also for animals and plants. It is also important for the agriculture purposes, especially for the purpose of irrigation. It means cultivation of crops. Okay, water helps the human body to maintain the temperature. Okay, it also helps in making cells and tissues to grow. Water is also crucial for maintaining the different body functions like breathing, digestion and sweating. Now, water industrial purposes, water is also used for the washing, processing, cooling and several other activities inside the industries. Okay, now we also came up to know that water is present in three forms, especially remember the names. Okay, first one is solid. Solid is in form of ice. Water is present in form of liquid, it means the normal water, and gaseous, it means the water vapor. Now, let us understand what is irrigation. Students, irrigation is a part of an activity where we provide water to the land for the agriculture purposes in a artificial manner. It means artificial over here, it means, see, we know that the water cannot be present everywhere. So for that, what we do? We used to create some sources by which we take the water from that area, divert it where the water is required and we use it. Just I'm giving an example. In your home, do every room is having a tap of water? No. We are having the water in the house, there in the kitchen or in the bathroom. Okay, now here, if we require water inside any room for washing the floor, what we do? We take the help of the bucket or bucket and a tumbler, or we take with the help of a pipe, rubber pipe. So what is that? The rubber pipe is said to be an artificial help or artificial source of getting the water. From one area, the water is coming to the another area. Same like here in the irrigation process, what happens that we divert the water of the rivers or the lakes, streams, ponds, etc. Okay, to the area where we require water for the irrigation. Some water is also being collected in a form of in the tanks or in the ponds, okay, especially by which they used to take the water whenever they require. This is what actually the irrigation stands for. Irrigation. Irrigation is the process of applying water to the crops artificially to fulfill their water requirements. Nutrients may also be provided to the crops through irrigation. The various sources of water for irrigation are wells, ponds, lakes, canals, tube wells, and even dams. Okay, so what actually you understood with the word of irrigation? Irrigation is the process of applying water to the crops artificially. Repeat once again with me. Irrigation is the process of applying water to the crops artificially to fulfill their water requirements. Okay, this is called irrigation. If the question comes to you, what is irrigation? What you will write? It is a process of applying water to the crops artificially to fulfill their water requirements. Now, nutrients may also be added or can be provided to the crops with the help of irrigation. Some various important sources of water for irrigation are wells, ponds, lakes, canals, tube wells, and even dams. Now, the important sources of irrigation available in India are the three main sources. They are the canals, wells and tube wells, and the taps. In villages, usually in villages, wells and tube wells are the major source of irrigation. Canal ranks second, while the tank ranks third. Canal irrigation has its maximum development in the Great Plains and in the Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna deltas in the eastern coastal plains. Wells and tube wells are popular in the alluvial plains, okay, where the alluvial soil is found in a huge quantity over there. Wells and tube wells are the very popular type of irrigation. So, what are the three major sources of irrigation in India? Number one, wells and tube wells. Number two, canals. And number three, tanks. Okay, now wells and tube wells rank first because it is the major source of irrigation. Canals comes in the second and the tanks comes in the on the third position. Canal irrigation has its maximum development in the Great Plains and in the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna in the eastern coastal plain. And wells and tube wells are popular in the alluvial plains. Now, sources of water. Over here, what are the sources which are being created by the man? It means man-made sources. Man-made sources are in the form of lakes, ponds, wells, tube wells. They all are being created by the human beings. Okay? So, lakes, pond, well and tube well. Usually, we find all such type of things in the villages area or in the coastal areas where they divert the water of one particular river or a main stream, okay, and take it in a collected form and just collect there as a source and use that water for the irrigation purposes. Now let us discuss about what are the canals. Although canal irrigation was introduced on a large scale only during the last century, it has already become the principal source of irrigation in the country because of its cheapness. Cheapness, it means very less amount is required for making a canal and using it, and the ease and certainly with which water is supplied. The irrigation canals of northern India rank almost the greatest and the most beneficent terms of modern engineering in the whole world. Canal irrigation. Now, canal irrigation is actually was introduced on a large scale, okay, in the last century, but at presently it has become the principal source for irrigation. And you know why? Because of its cheapness. It means very less amount is required for making up a canal and applying or using the water. The ease and the certainty, certainly with the water can be supplied easily. The irrigation canals of northern India, they rank among the greatest and the most beneficent terms of modern engineering in the whole world. It means the canals of India, especially for the northern part, northern India, they rank the very important and comes at the greatest position in the whole world. Next is tube wells. Tube wells are common in areas where the water table is rather deep, say over a 15 meter at least. The subsoil water is exploited through deep well pumping. Now look, students, tube well is usually a very common source of taking the water useful for irrigation purposes. Over here, how can we use our tube wells? Tube wells are basically being used where water is underground. It means the groundwater is being utilized for the irrigation purpose. The water table or the water should be deep inside the earth at least around 15 meters. Okay. Now, Indo-Gangetic Valley and in certain coastal, the deltic area, it means the areas of the great deltas, okay, coastal deltas, tube well is very common source for utilizing for irrigation. Now, understand again what is a tube well. Tube well is a source of water which where we, you can use the underground water for the help of or for the function of irrigation. Okay, the water over there should be deep inside the earth at least around 15 meters. Indo-Gangetic areas, okay, and the coastal deltic areas, over there tube well is a common source of irrigation. The states like Punjab, Bihar, Haryana and Gujarat have number of tube wells in different locations where the people uses the underground water for the purpose of irrigation and other sources. So, what do you understood with the tube well? Tube well is a source of water, man-made source of water, where the underground water is used for fulfill the requirement of water. It can be used for the household purposes, it can be used for the agriculture purposes and other needs. Okay, now the especially the area of Indo-Gangetic plain and the coastal deltaic areas, over there the common tube the tube wells are very commonly used. The states like Punjab, Haryana, Bihar and Gujarat, they have a number of tube wells in different locations. Now, let us discuss about tank irrigation. Tank irrigation is the most feasible and widely practiced method of irrigation all over the peninsula. You all know what do you mean by peninsula? Peninsula is an area which is covered by the three sides of water bodies and only one side with the land, where most of the tanks are small in size and built by individuals or group of farmers by raising banks across a seasonal streams. Now, what do you mean by banks? It means a boundary type with the help of the mud. Tank irrigation has reached its highest perfection south, especially in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, especially its highest perfection is in south. Why in south? That I will tell you. But what are the places? Where are the places where the tank irrigation is highly used? They are especially in Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. State in of West Bengal and Rajasthan too have some irrigation tanks, particularly in their southern and the southeastern regions respectively. It means the West Bengal and the Rajasthan, in the southern part of the Rajasthan, in the southern part of West Bengal and southern eastern part regions especially, the tank irrigation is being used. Punjab, UP, Bihar have also some tanks. Now, what is actually the tank irrigation? Tank irrigation is the most feasible, it means very easy to use, okay, and widely practiced method of irrigation all over the peninsula, where most of the tanks are small in size and are built by individual or a group of farmers by raising banks across a seasonal stream. Tank irrigation has reached its perfection in south, especially in Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. States of West Bengal and Rajasthan, they also use this tank irrigation, especially in the southern part or in the southern eastern part. But states like Punjab, UP and Bihar, they are also using some forms of or some types of the tank irrigation. Next is dam. What are dams? Dams are usually a large walls which are being constructed between the flow of any river or any stream. Okay, over there the water is being stopped in the middle and the water is being utilized for either for irrigation purposes or for creating or generating the electricity also. Here the water is always collected in a very huge form, okay, and whenever required, it also helps, the dams also help for over flooding the areas, okay. When the flood used to come, if the dams are being there, obviously these dams help or gives an opportunity to protect the living beings from the flooding of the area, okay, over flooding with the water. So let us discuss the dams. What are the dams and how the dams are being used for the irrigation purposes? Dams, structure building across a stream, a river or a estuary to retain water. Retain water means to stop water and to reutilize the water. Dams are built to provide water for human consumption, for irrigating, okay, for irrigation, irrigating arid and semi-arid lands, okay, or for the use of industrial processes. They are all used to increase the amount of water available for generating hydroelectric power. It means the electricity is being generated by the water collected in the dams, okay, to reduce the peak discharge of flood water created by large storms or heavy snow melt. Okay, now what does it mean? As I told you all that the dams also help the area to get flooded, okay, over flooded with the water. Usually when the heavy rainfall occurs over there, the water level rise up and it used to create flood in the nearby the areas of the river banks. So if the dams are been present there, it used to help to control the flow of water and let the human being safe and secure, or to increase the depth of the water in the river. Now, in order to improve the navigation and allow barges and ships to travel more easily. Yes, if the water flow is in a great quantity, in a high speed, obviously the ship also, the ships also, the huge cruisers also, they are unable to move forward and perform their functions. So the dams also used to help them to move properly and do their work easily and travel easily. Dams can also provide a lake for recreational activities such as swimming, boating and fishing. Yes, this is also a very good quality of the dams, that are characteristics of dam, that the dams also provide small lakes to construct, okay, with the help of the dam, with the help of the water collected in the dams over there, they can utilize a small area in form of a lake where the people can go for fishing, boating or swimming. Many dams are built for more than one purpose, okay. Usually the dams are not only built for just for one purpose, for the irrigation. No, dams are used, usually are being made for the multi-purpose projects, like creating of the hydroelectricity, it means creating electricity, okay. Second, using the water for irrigation purposes, and the third one, using the water for the human beings, living beings, for their fun activities, like you have I told you all, for boating, fishing and swimming, etc. Okay, so there are so many things whereby which we can use the glass of water provided by the dams. Water is a single reservoir, can be used for fishing, to generate hydroelectric power and to support an irrigation system. Water control structures of this type are often designated multi-purpose. Okay, so usually any dams which are doing so many things at one time, it means generating the electricity also, using the water, giving the water or providing the water for irrigation purposes, and also for the fishing purposes the water is being used. So there, such type of dams are usually been known as the multi-purpose dam. They are not performing a single one work, but they are performing multi-purpose task, okay. They are helping for the fishing cultivation also, okay. Now next, they are also helping to generate the hydroelectric power, and they are also helping for the irrigation system. So usually water dams are the structure built across a stream, a river or an estuary to retain water. Dam used to provide water for the human consumption, for irrigation and for the industrial purposes too. Especially the water of the dams are being used or utilized, or they help support in generating the hydroelectricity for the functions, for other purposes. Next is, now let us discuss about the water conservation. Water conservation refers to reducing the usage of water and recycling wastewater for different purposes such as cleaning, manufacturing and agriculture irrigation. You all know that water is a very important source for living beings, for surviving on this planet Earth. Now, not only for the human beings, but also water is essential element for plants and animals. It not only helps in the formation of or the utilizing for the domestic work, but it is also used for the irrigation purposes and for the manufacturing purposes. So, it means that water should be conserved very nicely, okay? And we should use the water and in a proper manner. We should not waste the water, and we should try that we should recycle the water use, okay? It means that we can just collect some water. Instead of throwing the water, we can reutilize in some other forms. Now, what are the benefits to conserve water? Water. If we use the water or we conserve the water, what the benefits they will give? Number one, if we save water, it can save your money bills. It means less amount of bills you will be have to pay to the government. Reduction in the interior water use cuts water waste water flows. It means at home, if we are saving the water, if we are conserving the water, if we are not wasting the water, obviously it will help to slow down the overflowing of the gutters, which contaminates the environment. It means which pollute the environment. Okay, bad smell and so many other diseases occurs. Environment benefits include ecosystem and habitat protection. Habitat protection over here means the protection related to us, the people who are living. Okay, as it will reduce and help in the ecosystem, obviously it will also reduce the number of diseases. And if the number of diseases will be reduced, what will happen over there? We will be protected from the diseases. Water conservation also helps in improving the quality of drinking water. The water conservation, if water conservation is being done, obviously it will also helps the quality of the drinking water that we utilize for our own selves. Now, do you all know that why we need to conserve water? What is the importance and why it is important to conserve the water? Number one, it used to guard against the rising cost and potential conflict. Now, what does it mean? It means that if we conserve the water, obviously it will reduce the your money bills. Okay, it will use or it will make you to expend the money more or very less for the water bills also, and also for the electricity purposes. Number second is, it used to help to prepare from protection against droughts. Now, what do you mean by drought? Drought is a type of an environmental process where with the lack of water, due to the lack of water, the land becomes barren, and over there the cultivation work is not being done. So it used to help prepare for future droughts. Now next is that the water can be easily available, or to make water easily available for the recreational purposes. Okay, the aquatic animals, how they can survive for a longer duration if the water not be present? Just imagine. So for those animals, for those aquatic animals, aquatic life, the plants, the animals, everyone, for those also we can save the water. To strengthen communities, obviously, see how we can strengthen communities over here, because if there will be a proper use of water, there will be no fights among between the neighbors, also among the neighbors, among the other people or the states fights. Okay, and if we, most importantly, if we conserve the water, we will preserve the environment, okay, for the coming generations. The people will not face any sort of problem for the coming generation if we are going to conserve the water. Now, I'm giving you all 4 tips. How can we conserve the water in the indoors? Indoors means inside your own home. Turn off faucet while brushing your teeth. When we are brushing our teeth, we should always close the tap of the sink. Okay, wash basin or the sink. Now, we should take shorter showers. Instead of wasting the water, opening the shower, okay, and we are having a shower for a longer duration, 1 hour or 2 hour or half an hour more than it, it's not required. Take a shorter shower. You should always fix leaks in the faucets, shower heads and the toilets. If any pipe is being broken or is cracked or leaked, we should quickly put some bandage or we should apply any tape or any other proper treatment should be done. We should fix those leaks by which the water should be conserved and it should not be wasted. Now, while nowadays every house is using washing machine for washing the clothes. Now, over there, how can we conserve the water here? We should always wash the clothes in the washing machine having the full loads. It means not only for 1 or 2 or 3 clothes we are using the washing machine. It's wrong. Okay, we should always use the proper quantity of the loads of the clothes while washing. Okay, now here by which the water can be utilized more and can be conserved too. Now, I am giving you the 4 tips. How can we help to conserve water outdoors? It means outside the house. When we are cleaning the outer area of the house, the gate area of the main entrance, we should always use a broom, not a hose to clean the driveway. It means many times the people are using the rubber tubes, okay, and they are just spreading the water to make the dirt out. Instead of that, you should always use a broom to clean that area. Use a rain sensor to regulate the sprinkling system. It means we should always, or the people can also collect the rainwater and they can reutilize this water for the further uses. Use a shut off nozzle. Now, what do you mean by shut off nozzle here? It means while watering the plant, we should not use the rubber tubes. Okay, we should always use an instrument which is specially meant for watering the plants. Now, watering the plants is not always required that we have to give the water unnecessarily also we have to give the water. No, we should always water the plants when it is required, when it is needed. If we see the sun or the of that water plant of that plant is gone dried up, obviously it is required for the water. What happens for our drinking? When we feel thirsty, then only we drink the water. We are not feeling thirsty, the water is not required. Same like here with the plants. When we find that the sand or the mud of the plants is being gone dried up, obviously the water is required, they are feeling thirsty. But if it is already wet, it means the moisture is already present over there, unnecessary watering the plants is not required. So, 4 tips I have given you all for the indoors also, and 4 tips how to conserve the water for the outdoor also. Now, in the next slide, I am giving you the 10 steps by which we can conserve the water and we can save the water on this earth. 10 steps how to save water. Number 1, spend at least amount of times in the shower. It means again the same thing, we should take short shower. Close the water tap while brushing your teeth. Don't use too many dishes, okay? 1 or 2 is sufficient. Unnecessary making so many dishes or varieties of dishes at one meal, in one meal, is not required. Check pipes for leaks. Water your lawn only when it needs water. Do not water it unnecessarily. Don't run the water hose while washing a car. It means do not wash the car with the help of a tube. tube, because that tube, that rubber tube, you to utilize the water in a huge quantity and it used to waste it. Now, don't use the toilet as an ashtray or waste basket. Now, what does it mean? It means that we should not use any of the solid things just as we are throwing any solid things in the dustbins, okay, in the waste baskets or the ashtrays. It means the puffs or the left part of the cigarettes for the which we are the people are using for the smoking purposes. We should not drain it in the toilets because it used to utilize more water. And how it utilizes more water? Because when the people used to flush, it do not go in the drainage system. It used to stop over there, and the people again and again require water to remove from that particular area. Wash the fruits and vegetables in one pan instead of washing separate. It means we should keep all the fruits and vegetables, whatever has been required for washing purposes, okay, at one space only, and we should wash them. We should not use one by one particular. For example, I have taken 1 kg of potato. Now over there I am using one potato. I am taking another potato for washing it. What is required? This is called the wasting of water. We can take the number of the potatoes required for my cooking. I will take in my pan, okay, and I will put inside beneath the water tap and I will wash it. This is the conserving of water. While cleaning your fish tank, don't throw the water and give it to the plants. See, many people nowadays are having aquarium at their home, where the small tiny fishes are being kept, and it looks very beautiful. Now, when the people used to clean that fish tank, usually the people used to throw the water. Instead of throwing that water, we can utilize that water in giving that water to the plants. Plants will easily absorb that water very nicely. So, by this also we can conserve the water. Students, water is a very important part, an essential component of our surviving in this earth, or on this earth, or on this planet. So we should take an oath for conserving the water, for saving the water. Now, one work I'm giving you all. You have to make a chart on an A4 size, or you can take a big chart also. Over there you have to make a beautiful make pictures, images, whatever you like to do, or make a beautiful drawing for save water. The heading will be conserve water or save water. You can take this heading, conserve water or save water, and you will explain with the help of the diagrams that how can we conserve the water or how can we save the water on the earth. Okay, read the chapter properly. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day ahead.